So it depends upon application to application. Now come to the Mac layer. What feature has been added which was previously there in the wireless communication protocol like 802.11? What extra has been added by 802.15.4? So what extra? It is adding the association of feature of association and disassociation. Association and disassociation means connecting and disconnecting the link between two nodes. Acknowledge frame delivery. Whenever a receiver will receive the data, it will send the acknowledgement. That facility has been added here. Next, channel access mechanism. How we are accessing the channel? What is the mechanism to access the channel? So there are different MAC protocols. There are different MAC protocols which are used by 802.15.4. So in all those MAC protocol, if we'll talk about, there is one MAC protocol which is called SMAC, sensor MAC. In the sensor MAC, what happened? Whole time is divided into two parts, active and sleep mode. Active mode and sleep mode. Active mode is again divided into two slots, receiving slot and sending slot. So whenever a node is in an active mode, it will either sending the data or receiving the data. And there is also a sleep idle mode, you can say. And there is a sleep mode. So half of the time, let's say if we have a cycle of 20 seconds, 10 seconds they are sleeping, 10 seconds they are active. In that particular 10 seconds, half of means 5 seconds is for the receiving and 5 seconds for the sending the data. So that type of channel access mechanism has been used. So every node will access the channel in that particular way. Okay. Frame validation, how much frame we are sending and receiving, that has to be validated by the MAC. Guaranteed time slot management means, I told you, there are guarantee that if you divide the slot, so there will be a sleep and there will be active. Active is again divided into receive and send. 5 seconds it is fully receiving, 5 seconds it is fully sending. So that 5 seconds is nothing but guaranteed time slot. So that guaranteed time slot should be matched with the receiver. Match with the receiver timing. So here there are different thing will come into the picture. Here comes the time synchronization also, right? So let's say in 10 o'clock, I am in my sending slot, right? I have a sending slot. So at that particular time, the node which to whom I am sending should be in a receiving slot. So the time synchronization is matter here. So I should know in what time that particular node is going to receive, and at that particular time I has to send. Now that thing has to be, so that is done by the guaranteed time slot management. And beacon management, beacon is just like sending a small signal to tell other node that I am alive now. So what will happen is, after some time, after receiving the data, the receiver will send a beacon signal that telling the sender that I am alive. If it will not receive the beacon signal, it will stop sending the data. Do you all get it? So it is just like if I am taking the lecture, if I am delivering you, if you are not telling me the acknowledgement that you are understanding or not understanding, if I am not getting it, I will stop. So this is a type of communication going on between two nodes. MAC, there is a packet frame of MAC protocol. Here also we have some bytes allocated. There is a frame control, sequence control, destination address, source address, payload and frame check sequence. Let's see one by one. Frame control, what is the use of frame control? Frame control is the first field of the frame, which basically tells about the type of frame being transmitted in the address format and handle acknowledgement. These are of four type. So the MAC frame control or the frame, so frame control will give the what type of frame or what type of data we are sending through the MAC protocol. So it is of 2 byte. So the MAC frames may be data frames. Yeah, either we are sending the data, so I have to tell the receiver that I am sending the data, or MAC command frame. that is not a data, that is a command or any type of control signals. So I have to tell the receiver that I am sending one control signal. Then there will be an acknowledgement frame. Whenever a node or a receiver will receive the data, it has to send the acknowledgement. So it has to tell that that particular signal which I am sending is an acknowledgement type. It is not a data type, it is a acknowledgement type. And then there is a beacon frame. So beacon frame, what I told you, it is a small signal just telling us that a receiver is alive or not, or sender is alive or not. Okay. Generally what will happen is when you use the Bluetooth and all, and you connect your Bluetooth device with your smart device or headphone or somewhere with the mobile phone. So what will happen is every 10 seconds there will be a beacon communication between your phone and your device. What is that beacon signal? Beacon signal will just tell that link is alive. The link between that device and my mobile phone is alive. Right? So that is a beacon. That is called beacon. It's just like a heartbeat. From the heartbeat we know that I am alive. In the same way, how those node will know that their channel or their communication channel is alive or their connection is alive. So for that they use beacons, right? So there are four frame. What are those? Data frame, then this command frame, which is also called control packets or control frames. Then there is acknowledgement frame and beacon frame. So frame are in this category. So 2 byte is enough to tell which type of category it is, because this is 4. You can denote it with 2 byte is also, I think, enough for that. It 1 byte will be enough, I think, because we have a 4 category. Either I can use 01, so it will find it out that is a data link. I'll use 10, it will find out a control. If I'll have 11, it will find out a. Are you getting it? 2 byte is enough for giving us 4 type of data frame. But what will happen is, in a longer time of the protocol, there will be many research used to going on, as well as many enhancement has been done, right? So maybe those frame size or the different frame types may be more in future. That's why they have reserved 2 byte for that. Now after that there is a sequence number. Sequence number field is used to match the acknowledgement frame. It's matching the acknowledgement means I am sending the, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 data I am sending. So I am getting one acknowledgement. This acknowledgement is for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 data. Or sometime what will happen, if I am sending data 1, it is sending me the acknowledgement 1. If I am sending data 2, it is sending me the acknowledgement 2. This is also a different protocol I can use. So here the communication is more, right? So different protocol has. So 1 byte is enough for this, to telling us what is the sequence. Then there is an address. So address is of it is varying between 0 to 20 bytes. Why it is varying from 0 to 20 byte? Because if I am using a sensor node doesn't follow IP addresses. What is the bit size of IPv4? Higher. Yes. Hello. Are you there in the class? Yes. Are you in the class or out of the class? Yes. You are in the class. What I asked? What I asked just now? You? What I asked? What I asked? IPv4. You are not in the class. Mobile ko andar rakho. This is not the place to use the mobile. So this destination and source address, why it is required? It is required for the MAC protocol for the one-to-one communication, one device to another device communication. This source address and destination address is required. So those wireless sensor network doesn't use IPv4 addresses. IPv4 is of 32 bit and IPv6 is 128 bit. So beyond the capacity of those sensor nodes. So they use some IDs. This ID size is 8 bit address. They use 8 bit address ID size. So from the 8 bit, how many address we can allocate? 256 addresses we can allocate. Okay, so one node will be connected, is allowed to connect 256 node in its range. Are you all getting it? So this is the phenomena of using 8 bit. So 8 bit, either it will use 8 bit or so it will use 64 bit IEEE device addresses. Means 32 for the sender and 32 for the receiver. Means if you are using IPv6. Sorry. Huh? Time out, yeah. Okay, so we'll close the class.